So students, what we are doing the topic rotational. Kinematics. So we have kinematics and dynamics. So kinematics means just motion. Okay. So we are concerned only about the motion, not about the force. So when we deal with force also, then it's dynamics. So cause of the motion when we are studying, then it's dynamics. Okay, and kinematics and dynamics makes mechanics. Okay, so definitely means we are going to study the motion, rotational motion and angular displacement. So this is the rotational motion. Can you see this what is written over here clearly or not? Means can you see the, can you read the, what is written there?
Rotational motion?
In your screen, yes, like the figure 8.1 when a rigid object rotates, can you read it? Are you able to read it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. See students, it's just sort of revision whatever we have done till now. So when a rigid object rotates like this, this man is rotating, okay? And it means it is not changing the position of his hands, okay? And you can see that at this point, so this is ice skating, right? So this skate, this skater is rotating. And you can see that it is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction or counterclockwise. So the points like A, B, C, they move on circular paths. Can you see? This is the path. It's like this. A will move on this circle, this circular path, B on this circular path, and C on this circular path. And the center of the circle form a line. So this is the center of the circle, this is the center of the circle, and this is the center of the circle. So if I join all these centers, so that is my axis of a rotation. So all the points of the rigid body, they move on circular paths. So radius might be different, but their centers will lie on the axis of rotation. Now, like, let us take this particular circle now, okay? So this is one of the circles, and with this, this, or any circle, okay? So now the radial line means this, the line passing through the radius. So this can be the radial line, like this is a radial line, okay? This is a radial line, okay, that we are talking about. So this radial line moves from an initial orientation of, so initially it was at this angle, theta naught. You can see from this reference line. So students, like we have the origin, right? In the when we talk about motion in a line or motion in a plane, we have origin, right? And we measure all the distances from origin. Okay, so here we have the reference line. So we measure all the angles from the reference line. So initially, like here the position was, this is at this much distance, and now the object has started moving and moved from this position to this position, suppose. So this is my final position. So how will you calculate the displacement here? So displacement is calculated by, yes, always delta x change, yes, tell me, that is equals to
xf minus xi.
Yes, always final minus initial. And Karthik, just remind me the question you asked, that is related with the torque. Okay, when we do the torque, we'll do that question. Okay, rotational motion. Okay,
yes, sir.
Means, rotational dynamics when we start, just remind me. Okay, so just like here we have delta x here, so this was our linear displacement, or simply So this was our linear displacement. Okay, this delta x. So similarly here we have angular displacement. Okay, so that's the same, means final theta f minus theta I. So theta f is the angle from reference line, theta I is also from the reference line. Like here we have distances xi position from the origin and xf position from the origin. So students, it's the same way. Okay, so I started from here and it was at position theta naught, and then I reached from here to here. So this is my theta f, and this means that this is my theta f. This whole angle is theta f. So here instead of theta f, he is writing it theta. Okay, got the point? So this theta naught is your means the position of the initial position, and so this is theta final minus theta initial. And if theta naught is zero, if I start from here instead of here, if I start from reference line, then my angular displacement will be theta, because theta naught is zero. So put theta naught is zero, delta theta is equals to theta. So the angular displacement of the, so here we are taking an example of, suppose this is circular, this is CD, compact disc, is the angle delta theta swept by radial line. So this is our radial line, and this is this sweeping out this angular displacement delta theta by the radial line as the disc turns about its axis of rotation. Okay, now if we only talk about theta, what this theta is now? Theta in terms of radius and arc length, we can write theta is equals to s by r. Or we also write theta is equals to, some of the time we write it as L instead of S. So we write it as L by R. Okay? And some of the time we take the radius as capital R also. So theta is equals to LR, or L is equals to R into theta. So all of them have the same meaning. So this was our angular displacement. This is what our theta is. And now, after the displacement, definitely there will be velocity. So what was our average linear velocity when we were studying velocity? So linear velocity was velocity is equals to displacement upon time taken, right? So this v was equals to xf minus xi divided by tf minus ti. Okay, so this is what our linear velocity is. So you can see that it is average linear velocity, because what will be the instantaneous? So this is your average linear velocity. Yes students, you tell me, how will we get the instantaneous velocity or simple velocity? Yes,
delta x by dx by dt velocity ka.
Okay, dx by dt. Okay, fine, dx by dt. So how do we get this dx by dt? How do we get this dx by dt? Suppose
this slope.
Yes, very good. This is the slope at that particular instant of the graph. Okay, so this is our graph. We means displacement upon displacement time graph. Okay, position time graph. This is a position time graph. Fine. And this is the curve. Now, suppose I want to find the means this is initial time over here, and this final time, and this is initial position, this final position. So my velocity from here to here will be the slope of this these points and this point. I'm joining these two points and I get a line. Okay, and now I will find the slope of this line. So the average velocity V average is equals to the slope of this line, okay, slope of this line, that is change in y-axis divided by change in x-axis. So that is my average velocity. Now I am interested in finding the velocity at any particular point on this curve. So suppose this point. So how will you find the slope of this point? Because there is very little change in x-axis and very little change in x-axis and very little change in y-axis. So actually at this point, if you want to find the average at this point, but what you will do, what you will do to find the average at this point? You will take the limit delta t tends to 0. Okay, so this delta t change is very small. You will be taking it very small because you want to find the average at this particular point. So you are taking this delta t, means this change in time, as small as possible. As small as possible. So then only this you will get. So when you take delta t tends to 0, then this formula, average formula, becomes instantaneous formula. So instantaneous is nothing but the average at a point. So what does this mean? This derivative means, this means the slope of this graph at this particular point. So slope of the graph at this particular point, this slope, this is your dx by dt. So what is dx by dt? Slope at an instant, at a point, slope at a point. This is the slope of a line. So when I take delta t tends to 0, this slope actually is of the particular point. So this is a slope at a point. So students, you must know the meaning of what is the difference between average and this instantaneous. I hope you have understood it, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so when I take the limit delta t tends to 0, so then this formula average becomes instantaneous, and this I write it as dx by dt. Okay, now what is this angular average angular velocity? So we will write it in the same way like we have written the linear velocity. So theta f minus theta I divided by tf minus ti. So this theta f final minus initial, and you can see that there is a bar. Either I write this v average or I will put a bar. Okay, so what will be the unit, students? This is very important. So this theta, as I have discussed you, that here theta is in radians. Okay, so theta is always, see, in physics it will be in radians, because you see in rotational motion theta will always be in radians, and at most of the places in physics you will find theta in radians, even in your maths also. So unless and until it is specified, the angle means if it is in radians, you need not to write the units, but if it is not in radians, it is in degree, you need to write the degree. Okay, so theta is in radian, because when you are using this formula, then means angle will be 1 radian. So some of the time we write this C as means C over here, means as like one C, a small C. So this is also radian, and we simply write 1, so that is also radian. If I write this theta, so if there is nothing I am writing over here, so it means it is radian. So 1 radian this, and I can also write it like this, 1 radian. Okay, so now when will the angle be 1 radian? When when this L is reaches here, so that the length L is equals to R. So when this arc length and arc length is equal to, see, radius is constant here, you are just increasing the arc length. So as the arc length is increasing, obviously theta is increasing, and when this arc length becomes R, then the theta is 1 radian. When this arc length, when it is 2L, then the theta becomes 2 radian. Okay, so what is 180 degree? Theta is equals to pi radian. So pi is, what is the value of pi? 3.14. So you can say that this theta is actually 3.14. Okay, now, so I hope you have understood this concept. So I've given some time over here, spent some time over, so that you remember this, that theta is to be taken in radians. So what are the units of angular velocity? Radians per second, and or revolution per minute, RPM. That you say, some of the time we say RPM. Like means when you study about car or any motor, so you will find their RPM. So RPM means revolutions per minute. Okay, and one revolution, you know, is equals to pi radian. Oh, sorry, 2 pi radian. So one revolution is equals to
two pi radian.
So first of all, what you need to do, because this is the SI unit, so understand this point. This is the SI unit, radians per second. Okay, so if you are given the unit, some of the time we get the units as revolution per minute. So you have to change the revolution per minute to radians per second. So change the whatever, suppose the, here I have 3 revolution per minute. Okay, so how will I write it? 3 into 2 pi radian divided by 1 minute is 60 second. So now these are the units of, so this is 6 pi radian. You can say this is 10. So, or 6 pi radian upon 60 seconds. So this is the SI unit. Now you can put this in your formulas. So SI units only you are supposed to put the values which are of SI units. Okay, students. So you'll get the given values of angular velocity in both the terms, radians per second or revolution per minute. If it is revolution per minute, change it into radian per second. Now the angular displacement, angular velocity is positive. When it is positive? When the rotation is counterclockwise. So what this rotation is counterclockwise. So when the rotation is counterclockwise, we take them as positive. Obviously you can see, because this is the reference line, and if you are moving in this direction, then it's positive direction. And if you are moving in this direction, so like here, if I move in this direction, this will be negative direction. If I move in this direction from origin, it will be positive direction. So similarly here, this is the positive direction. So counterclockwise is positive, and clockwise is actually, if you move this direction, so this is negative. Okay, and here the theta will be, the displacement will be negative theta. Okay, so it is negative when it is clockwise. Got this point, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now let us come to instantaneous. Tell me, so when this formula will be changed to instantaneous at a particular instant, when do we get a particular instant? When this delta t will tends to
zero.
Delta t tends to zero. Okay, so when this delta t tends to zero, I will write it as delta t, and then further I will write it as d theta by dt. So there is no bar sign over here. Okay, so students, just you know, keep on writing down in your notebooks these formulas, at least important formulas. Now we have studied displacement, we have studied velocity. What will be now? Acceleration. Okay, so now average angular acceleration, of course the formula will remain the same. Acceleration is equals to initial velocity, final velocity minus initial velocity, final time minus initial time. So delta, so here the symbol is alpha for angular acceleration. So what is average angular acceleration? That is delta omega upon delta t. And what will be the units? Like there, the unit is meter per second linear acceleration. Here it will be radian per second square. So students, meter is changed with radians. Okay. Now in rotational motion, again, if alpha is constant, means if angular acceleration is constant, then you can use this same formula, replace the, so you have done two replacement, you have replaced s with, what you have replaced s with, theta, okay, and you have replaced further a with alpha, okay, and you have replaced further what, u to omega naught and v with omega, right? So these are the four changes and you will get these equations. Like this is v is equals to u plus at, this s is equals to this is average actually, okay, so this is like, see this formula is like s is equals to upon into t divided by 2. So this formula, this is something like, so students, whenever there is any problem, write them in the form of your linear. So this is what is like omega naught is your u and this is your v, so u plus v by 2, okay, into time. This is this formula I'm writing. So this is nothing but like, this is the you can further write it as like final velocity vf plus initial velocity vi is equals to this. So what is the average velocity? So average velocity you can write v average into t. So because when the acceleration is like constant, so we can always use this formula, v average into time. So average velocity into time, we'll get the displacement, okay? So this simply, this formula is this is your average angular velocity multiplied by time. So we have this formula over here also. Usually we write these three equation 1, 2, 3, s is equal to ut plus half at square and v square is equal to u square plus 2as, but this is also one of the formula that we average into t, so we use it, okay? But got it? And we also write v average is equals to displacement upon time, isn't it? We use this formula, v average is equals to total displacement divided by time taken, isn't it? Yes.
Yes, sir.
So students, I hope that these basic concepts are clear to you. Shall we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, see, like you have seen that when there is any like competition race, 100 meters. So 100 meters, all of them, you know, stand on the same line, okay? Because they are moving in the straight lines. But when there is a 400 meters race, so then they need to, you know, move in this path. And here we have semicircles, okay? So that case I'm taking. So now this this is the case of skates. In skates also, suppose this. So this if they are standing on this line, okay, so one is at the center, one is over here, one is over here, one is over here. So this first one which is remain at the center, so all of them are supposed to be on the same line all the time. So if they are here, all of them are supposed to be on the same line. So this is not a race actually, This is a performance. We are performing in such a way that all of us will be on the same line all the time. Okay? Is this clear? This is what is the meaning of rigid body? Yes?
In the rotation. Yes, sir.
So all of them will be in the same line. Now tell me, who will cover the largest distance? Tell me, who will cover the largest distance? So the, suppose this is 1, 2, 3. So who will cover the largest distance? So, this is a circular motion. And these are the four person who always remain at the same point. So this is my A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So here also A, B, C, and D. Here also B, C, and D. Tell me, do we need A to move?
No, sir.
Do we need A to move?
No, sir.
No, absolutely. Now, who is traveling? Okay. Is their angular displacement same?
Yes, sir.
Yes, their angular displacement is same. Yes. Delta theta is same. But delta L or delta S, whatever you say, okay, this is different. Agreed or not agreed?
Yes, sir.
So whose delta S is maximum?
D.
D. So delta S of D is maximum, then?
C.
C. Delta S of C, then?
B.
B. And what about delta S of A?
What is zero.
D- yes, zero. Very good. So students, this is what we need to understand. Okay? Now, we know this formula, that that's the same S, or you can say, write L, R is equals to, L is equals to R theta, that's the same formula. And what is R equals to? So,
the radius.
Yes. So, R is the radius. So, we write, like we know the relation, and we can derive this relation over here. Very simply, that S is equals to R theta, and divide both sides with respect to T. Divides both sides with respect to, okay, so what do we get? S upon T is your tangential velocity. So what is the direction of this point D over here? It will always be tangential. This will always be like this is the motion. This C, it will always be tangential. At this point, suppose they are at this point, this is the velocity. So I can write it as S by T, tangential velocity. What is VT? VT is, so it is always, so what is the direction of motion at this point? Actually, what is the direction of motion at this point? So due to centripetal force, they are moving in circle. So if there is, if I remove the centripetal force, then instead of moving in the circle, they will move in this direction. They'll move in this direction if I remove the centripetal force. Okay? So that is actually the direction of the motion. At any particular point, draw a tangent to it. Yes, this is what we do. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this is the direction of tangential velocity. Got it? So this S by T is my tangential velocity, and this theta by T is my angular velocity. So tangential velocity is equals to R into omega. So V is equals to omega R. We have this formula. Yes. We have written this formula. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And how do we write it in vector form? Cross product. Yes, tell me. Yes, we always have to put our fingers, we need to start our fingers from omega or from R, where we need to put our foot, the fingers of our right hand. Yes,
in the direction of omega.
Yes, in the direction of omega, and then we need to rotate them towards
R.
Yes, so V is equals to omega cross R. All three of them are perpendicular to each other, all three of them in this case. Okay, so one is suppose x-axis, one is suppose y-axis. So this V will be along z-axis, and if you are taking V along suppose x-axis and R along y-axis, so omega will definitely be towards the z-axis. Okay, so we start from omega, which is z-axis, vertical. So always this is important thing, so you can just visualize it. Actually we take omega as z direction, we take or if you like take the floor of means floor as xy plane, means then we are taking this. Okay, so this height of the means the room. Okay, so assuming this circle on the floor, okay, and this omega is your height, like vertical direction, and this R is actually your, you can consider it as x-axis. Okay, so V is along the, V will be along the y-axis, so this will be the tangent. So draw this on the floor, and your wall vertically upwards is your omega, so cross them from omega to R. Okay, so thumb will be in the y direction. Got this point, students? Visual, can you able to visualize it? V is equals to omega cross R. So what happens is that in almost all the cases, omega and R are at 90 degree. Okay, so that is why when sine theta is 90, we get it as 1. And we know the direction of V. So we write, so what is the direction of V? So V will be perpendicular to the plane containing omega and R. So we write it as tangential velocity Vt is equals to omega R, because you know, most of the time this theta is 90. So if this theta is 90 degree, we write this formula Vt is equals to omega R. So Vt is equals to omega R. So it's better, students, if you write omega R instead of writing R omega. I prefer to write it as omega R, because finally it is actually omega cross R. Okay, why do we write it R omega then? See, because R is constant, so we write like if we need to write 2x, so we write 2 earlier. So R is constant, so we bring R. So have you got it? So whenever you will find V, you will find V is equals to R omega in your books. Because R is constant, so we write the constants earlier. That is why we always write R as a coefficient. Now, what will be the tangential acceleration? So this will be the direction of R. So this is the direction of, so we have two acceleration. One is centripetal acceleration, which is towards the center, and another is, so this is the centripetal acceleration towards the center. AC is equals to V square by R. Okay, so which V we are talking about? The V that we are talking about is a tangential velocity. Okay, so now we, as we have this tangential velocity, obviously if I'm taking uniform circular motion, then the speed is constant, but the direction is changing, so it means velocity is changing, because magnitude remains the same but direction is changing. So that acceleration is tangential acceleration. So I hope you have studied it in chapter number 15-16 also. Yes? Yes or no? Students?
Yes, sir.
So we have two accelerations now, centripetal acceleration and a tangential acceleration. We know the formula of centripetal acceleration, that is V square by R. Okay? But what will the formula for tangential acceleration? So tangential acceleration means tangential velocity minus final tangential velocity minus initial tangential velocity divided by time taken. So what is my final tangential velocity? That is equals to r omega minus, this is initial angular velocity, this is final angular velocity, and r is common. So what this equals to? This is equals to my alpha. So these relations are derived over here. Okay, so this is the first result and this is the second result. So we have derived here, so we have studied earlier alpha we did in last in the last slide, and here we are deriving what? Because angular velocity and angular acceleration we did it, means yes. So this is what we have did, what we did in the last slide, and this omega is equal to theta by t. So angular velocity and angular acceleration, these formulas, and now we are deriving tangential velocity and tangential acceleration. So students, I hope you have understood. So we have what velocities do we have? So this is the angular velocity and this is the tangential velocity. This is the angular acceleration and this is the tangential acceleration. So what is angular velocity? So angular velocity is theta by t. What is tangential velocity? Tangential velocity is r omega, or you write it as omega cross r. Okay, so this is the same formula, that is equals to omega cross r. Okay, so this is the first formula, this is the second formula. Now the third one is so this is angular velocity, this is tangential velocity. Okay, this is angular acceleration, this is tangential acceleration. Got it? So what is the angular acceleration? Angular acceleration is simply here. So this is the special case, theta by t. So always see in your books, you will find omega is equal to theta by t. So this is omega is equal to theta by t when omega I is equals to 0 and we are taking omega f as a theta. Is this clear? So what is angular acceleration? So angular acceleration means final minus initial divided by delta t, time taken. Okay, and what is this tangential acceleration? Tangential acceleration is r into alpha. So like it is so it is in the same manner like we have vt is equals to r omega. Similarly we have vt is equals to r alpha. So I don't think that these are difficult to remember. Okay, simple. Now students, this is let us read here. There is an advantage to using angular velocity omega and the angular acceleration alpha to describe the rotation motion. So why do we have the advantage? So now we have the choice. Would you be taking angular velocity or tangential velocity? Will you be taking angular acceleration or tangential acceleration? So you have the choice now. Okay, so which one you are going to take? Tell me. While describing this rotational motion, you can see that tangential velocity will be different for different points. Yes, for different particles, this tangential velocity will be different for different particles. But angular velocity will be same for all the particles. Yes or no? That we have discussed earlier also. That delta theta is same, angular displacement is same, whereas linear displacement is different for different. So linear displacement is different, so tangential velocity will be different. So, and similarly, angular acceleration is same for all particles of the body, of the rigid body, and tangential velocity is different, right? Got this point, friends?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, sir.
So there is an advantage to using angular velocity omega and angular acceleration alpha to describe the rotational motion, because they are same. The advantage is that these angular quantities describe the motion of the entire object. So because it is same for all the object, so we can say that this is for entire object. Okay, this for entire object. In contrast, the tangential velocities, tangential quantities like tangential velocity and tangential acceleration, they describe only the motion of a single point on the object. So different points located at different distances are, because r is changing for all of this. So like this, for this r is this, for this the r is this, for this the r is this. So this is like this one, the radius of b is not equal to so because here rb, rc and rd are all different, right? So if they are different, so if this r is different for different bodies, so definitely the tangential velocity, and here both of them depends on the distance of the particle from the axis of rotation. So if you are changing the distance from the axis of rotation, so the tangential velocity and acceleration velocity will be different. Yes. So this is very important discussion, students, but it is very easy. So if you do it systematically, okay. So different points located at different distances have same, have different tangential velocity and different acceleration. Why? Because the distance from the axis of rotation, which is r, is different. But this omega, angular velocity and angular acceleration, they do not depend on the distance from the origin. Okay, they only depend on the angle. So the angle is same. So the theta, delta theta is same for all of them. And that is why the this omega and alpha will be same for all the particles. And we see, we can say that this is the angular velocity of the object and this is the angular acceleration of the entire object. Now, students, if you need to find out, if I simply say acceleration, so, or if I simply say velocity, so if I simply say acceleration, then this is your tangential acceleration, this is your centripetal acceleration. So what will be the net acceleration? Yes. So this is like vector addition. We have to add both the accelerations, and as parallelogram law, we get this net acceleration. So acceleration of the particle is this, and what will be the, so you can always find this angle phi. So 10 phi is equals to 80. This is your 80. So 80 upon AC. Okay, perpendicular upon base. So you can find the direction of the acceleration of the particle. Is this clear? And and if it is object, of the object. So this is a toy plane. This boy is rotating this toy plane. So what is the acceleration? So that is equals to, what is the magnitude of this acceleration? So when we are telling the acceleration, so you need to tell its magnitude and its direction. Okay, so magnitude is definitely by hypotenuse theorem. So perpendicular square upon base square under the root. So now if you look at this figure, so in this figure point means this 1 and 2 on the rotating blades of the helicopter, this is point 1 and this is point 2. Okay, they have the same angular speed and acceleration, but they have different tangential speeds and acceleration. When I am talking about speed, it means I am not considering the direction. I am only talking about the, so students, have you understood the like velocities? And I can write it as angular speed and angular acceleration. So, and then similarly, I will have tangential speed also and tangential acceleration also. So angular speed is nothing, But the magnitude of angular velocity, angular acceleration is nothing but the magnitude of angular acceleration. Tangential speed is nothing but the magnitude of tangential velocity, and tangential acceleration is nothing but the magnitude of tangential acceleration. So this is tangential acceleration. So their magnitude will be different because R is different. Okay, got this point, students? So now this figure. Why don't all of you say yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, if a model plane flying on a guide wire has a constant tangential speed, the motion is uniform circular motion. So when do we call it uniform circular motion? When the tangential speed is a constant. So we say the speed is constant, so it's better if you say tangential speed is constant and the plane experiences only centripetal acceleration. So this that's the point. So there is a means tangential velocity because the magnitude is same, but the direction is changing. Non-uniform, so this is the example of uniform circular motion. In non-uniform circular motion, when the tangential speed is changing, so here your tangential speed is also changing, so then there is tangential acceleration. So if the tangential speed is changing, then only there will be, so here the tangential acceleration is not this, tangential acceleration is zero. So it is equals to zero here. Why? Because Vt is equals to zero. Okay, why Vt is equals to zero? Because Vt is equals to R into omega. This change in, of course this is change. So change in, this is Vt is equals to, sorry. How do we write it? So tangential acceleration is zero. Why? Because change in tangential velocity is zero. Okay? Because change in tangential velocity is zero. So students, just understand this point, that if change in velocity is zero, of course the acceleration will be zero. So At is zero because alpha is equals to zero. So when alpha is equals to zero, then only At can be zero. So when can alpha be zero? Alpha is zero when omega f is equals to omega I. Okay, so here this omega f is equals to omega I. So tangential acceleration is zero. So again, it's better if we write it as alpha is equals to zero, means change in angular velocity is zero. Okay, so change in, so tangential speed is not zero. Again, I'm getting it. So change in, if it is moving at the tangential velocity of 3 meters per second, like very simple case, let us take. So it is taking 3 meters per second is the tangential velocity. So what is the tangential acceleration? Tangential acceleration will be zero because there is no change in tangential velocity. Okay, simple as that. So here, because this At is zero, so At is zero, so your acceleration will be equals to AC only. So here in this case, A is equals to AC is equals to this. So for uniform circular motion, there is no tangential acceleration, so we write it, we say it acceleration or centripetal acceleration is the same thing. But when there is non-uniform circular motion, then the acceleration and the centripetal acceleration are different. Okay, so that's the main point over here. So non-uniform circular motion occurs when the tangential speed changes. changes. Okay, like here Vt is equals to 3, then Vt is equals to 4, Vt is equals to 5, Vt is equals to might be lesser again. So then there is tangential acceleration in addition to centripetal acceleration. So in addition to centripetal acceleration, we have tangential acceleration. So here the tangential acceleration is here. Got it, students?
Yes, sir.
And I will post this video so you can watch it again at any point of time. So now let us move forward. So now let us talk about rotational dynamics now. So you have studied rotational kinematics, you know the equations, you know the velocities, acceleration, right? So and you know how to find the even direction of angular. So you know the direction of students. Let me go back. What is very important point? So you have these four quantities: angular velocity. So what is the direction of angular velocity?
Towards the axis.
Yes. Yes. Where is the direction of angular velocity?
Towards the axis.
Towards the axis. Very good. Okay. It is along the axis of rotation, you can say. Yes. Along the axis of rotation. Very good. So, see, like, remember we consider over here this z-axis, x-axis and y-axis. So, if you want to find out, suppose, the direction of angular velocity, what you are going to do? This circle, you want to find out the direction of angular velocity, what you are going to do? Curl the fingers of your right hand. Put your right hand on this circle and curl your fingers in the direction of motion and put your curled fingers on this circle. Can you put your curled fingers on this circle? Yes?
Yes, sir.
So what is the direction of angular velocity? So
out
of the plane, perpendicular to the plane, because I told you that this V, omega and R. So this is your Vt. What is the direction of Vt? This is the direction of Vt. And this is the direction of R, right? This is the direction of R. This is the direction of R, like, okay? Direction of R, direction of this is Vt. So this is the direction of R. So they are in xy plane. This is your x-axis. This is your you can consider this as a y-axis. Okay, so x-axis, y-axis. So where will be your omega? It will be in the z-axis. So vt is vt, vt, r and omega, all three are along the three axis. They are orthogonal, right? All three of them are always perpendicular to each other. So that is very important point in rotational motion. You need to know the direction. And direction is given by, so if you are using this, direction of velocity is given by right hand thumb rule. So ultimately we know that x and y, this direction. So curl your fingers and the direction of this angular velocity is coming out of the plane. Okay, so perpendicular to the xy plane coming out. And if it is clockwise, then what will be the direction of angular velocity?
Inside the plane.
Yes. So if it is coming out of the plane, then suppose you have an arrow. So if it is coming out, you will see the tip of the arrow. So this is how do we write. So this is coming out of the plane. So this is the symbol that we use for coming out. Okay, is this clear? So here the direction of omega, angular velocity is actually coming out of the plane. And if it is going in, then how do we write it? Then we see the back of the arrow. The arrow is, if the arrow is coming out, means arrow is moving towards you, you will see the tip of the arrow, right? And if the arrow is moving away from you, what do you see? You see a cross sign going away, right? Going away. So students, these are the symbols that we'll be using in physics. We'll start using, we can use it in 11th class also, but in 12th class you'll find these two symbols, okay, of when the direction is coming out of the plane, you use this symbol. When the direction is going away or going into the plane, so then we use this cross. Is this clear to everyone? How to tell the direction of the so we know the direction of the angular velocity and we know the direction of the tangential velocity, okay? So this tangential velocity is angular velocity cross the this position, and here the position is position vector of this point, so that is equals to the radius here, okay? But always remember that this direction is coming out from the origin. Position vector is from the origin, so don't take it inside. Is this okay? So here also you can see means this omega and cross r, so that's the position of your this is your position of your omega is coming out of the plane, so and you will get vt. So that so I think that students, the time is over today, but and so tomorrow we will start with we'll proceed further with the dynamics, rotational dynamics. So today